Welcome to the 60 by 120 Premiere 2 High Peak Pole Tent installation video by Celina. Prior to installation, call the local utility locating service and have all utilities located and marked. This chart shows industry standard colors for marking utilities. A tent installer should never use these colors for marking. Always use white paint for tent squaring and layout. Arrange the tent to avoid all utilities at the installation site. The tent squaring procedure should be performed at the site where the tent is to be installed. Tent squaring saves time during installation and ensures that the tent is tensioned properly. Using white marking paint, mark all stakes, side poles, corner poles, and center pole locations per the layout handbook illustration. Step 1. Lay out all necessary hardware on the tent perimeter. Each lace line requires 2 box ratchets, 4 2-hole stake plates, and 6 double-head tent stakes. 1 box ratchet, 1 2-hole stake plate, and 2 double-head tent stakes are required at the remaining grommet locations. Each corner location requires 8 double-head tent stakes, 5 2-hole stake plates, and 3 box ratchets. 4 stake plates will be set 90 degrees apart and a 5th stake plate at 45 degrees. The ratchet must be facing in towards the tent. Place the stake plate on top of the box ratchet, aligning the stake holes. Drive the stakes vertically all the way down until the bottom head is flush with the stake plate. Continue this process until all box ratchets and stake plates are secured. Vertical is defined as straight up and down or an angle away from the tent up to 10 degrees. Step 2. Unfold the drop cloth to cover the desired location of the tent. Always use a drop cloth. Be sure all areas are covered to prevent damage and or dirt from touching the tent top. Step 3. There are 4 tent sections required to install a 60 by 120 Premiere 2 pole tent. Place all sections on the drop cloths. 60 by 30 foot end section, 60 by 30 foot midsection, 60 by 30 foot midsection, 60 by 30 foot end section. All lace lines on the Premiere 2 tents are universal lace lines, so they will match up no matter how the tent sections are laid out. The tent end sections and the mid sections are identical. It takes 2 identical ends and 2 identical mid sections for the 60 by 120 Premiere 2 tent. Unroll and unfold all sections in their appropriate locations. Do not stand or walk on tent top fabric. If a section must be moved or relocated, do not drag it. The section must be picked up and carried to the desired location. Step 4. Lace all tent sections together. Start by lining up the 2 large center steel rings and plates that are attached to the tent top located on the center edge of the tent sections. With the floor flange and nipple, insert the nipple through the steel ring and plate on one tent section. And the steel ring and plate on the other tent section to create 1 solid center pole pin location. Secure the end of the nipple with the floor flange. From the center of the tent, working to the outside perimeter, pull the first lace up through the first small grommet. Pull the next lace through the grommet and previous lace loop. while lacing a Premier 2 tent top. Be sure to also connect the rain flap with the Velcro covering the lace line. This eliminates the need to crawl in the tent after it is laced. The rain flap prevents water from penetrating the lace line. Continue lacing the sections together until you reach the double length lace. Double length laces are located approximately 2 feet above the tent valance. Insert the two last laces through the grommets. Starting from the lace closest to the valance, loop upwards back to the longest lace. Tie a knot at the longest lace location to secure the entire lace line. Repeat the above method to secure the remaining tent sections. Step 5. Attach the tie-back straps to the plates on the tent top and box ratchets. At the end of each lace line, there are two plates and one plate at each remaining grommet locations. Each plate has two holes. At the lace line, make sure the two side pull holes are lined up together. Hook the tie back to the plates at each lace line and grommet locations. Feed the webbing straps attached to the tent top through each box ratchet. Turn the ratchet several times and secure the webbing loosely. Step 6. Place one side pole at each grommet location and one larger 3.5-inch diameter pole at each corner location around the tent. Step 7. The tent's side poles and corner poles are now ready to be set. The corner poles are larger than the side poles. Starting at a corner location, insert the pole pin through the metal plate and the brass grommet. Be sure the pole pin goes through both holes. If done improperly, you can puncture the tent top fabric and create holes. Set the corner pole to its upright position. Tighten the webbing straps to keep erect. The remaining side and corner poles can now be erected. Work around the tent. Do not over-tension the webbing straps. Secure poles with jump rope. Step 8. Assemble the center poles. If there are multiple piece center poles, make sure the poles are bolted together. Step 9. Insert the first center pole pin through the nipple and the powder-coated stainless steel plates, coupling the center pole plates and rings together. Be sure not to pinch or puncture the tent top fabric. Celina Tent recommends using a winch device, if possible, to help lift the center pole. There are many different types of winches available. Be sure to find one that fits the application and is also strong enough to support the weight of the center poles. Make sure to follow safety procedure when raising and lowering center poles. The center poles require a lot of manpower to lift into place. Celina Tent recommends using a lift assist device for the first center pole at a minimum. Set the base of the pole on the lift assist and secure with a pulling strap. It is important to make sure the center pole ropes are attached prior to raising the center poles, and the center poles are secure while they are being raised so that nobody is injured. Lift the center pole into an angled position. Insert the second center pole through the second O-ring assembly. Lift the pole into an angled position. Insert a tent stake into the helper hole if available. Repeat this process for center pole 3. Step 10. When the tent fabric is elevated and no longer touching the ground, the drop cloth can be removed from around the center poles. Step 11. Raise all center poles into their vertical positions. It's necessary to use larger anti-sink pole plates for the center and corner poles. Step 12. The remaining drop cloths can now be removed. Step 13. Tighten all corner box ratchets until they are vertically straight. Align the bottom of each side pole in a straight line using a masonry string. Applying even amounts of tension, tighten the secondary side pole box ratchets until all side poles are vertical and the tent top is tensioned. Step 14. Finish the tent by rolling excess ratchet straps into ratchet buckle. The tent installation is now complete. If sidewalls are desired, clip the sidewall snap hooks to the rope line that is attached to the tent top. Celina Tent is an industrial fabric products manufacturer of tents, shelters, canopies, and related accessories. All tents can be custom printed with your corporate logo, brand, or marketing information. For more information or to order online, please visit our website at gettent.com.